In this video, we will see how to create a custom immutable class. Immutable dictionary meaning is unchangeable or unmodifiable. So once we do something, it cannot be changed. That means that is immutable. With respect to class, what is immutable? So we will see that one. Immutable classes means once an object is created, we cannot change its state or content. That means once we create the object of class, so whatever state is there while creating, that cannot be changed. That is the immutable. Mutable means we can change the value of that content of that object or state of object. So here main thing is immutable objects don't expose any way for other objects to modify their state. We will see all those things in later. So you can understand completely what is immutable class and how to create that immutable class by our own. I mean custom immutable class by end of this video. Okay, so in Java already there are built-in classes which are immutable, like wrapper classes. You know, there are 8 wrapper classes are there. Those are also immutable classes. Once we create the object of those immutable classes, we cannot change content of that object at any point. That is immutable class. So more famous one, string also immutable class. Once we create object of that string, we cannot change at any cost content of that object. That is also immutable. If you see this table, these are the wrapper classes and primitive data types. So these are the classes for which we can create the object. These are the primitive data types. We cannot create the object for these. Hope you all aware of this one. Okay, this byte, short, integer, long, float, double, boolean, character. These are the wrapper classes in Java. So hierarchy, just for information, I am providing this. Like in Java, supermost class or else topmost class is a object class. This is a interview question. Definitely 50 to 60% interviews. This question will be asked for 1 to 5 years experience guys. So what is the super class, super most class in Java? So answer is object. So number, character, boolean, these are the subclasses of object class. Again, byte, short, integer, long, float, double, these are the subclasses of number. So these are the subclasses. The subclasses super class is number. Number super class is object. So supermost class is object for all these classes. So for example, if you define any custom class, so if you don't extend that one, automatically object class will be extended by your custom class. So that logic will be added by compiler. We don't know while defining. After compilation, if you see that compiled code, we will come to know there is extend will be added with object class. Okay, so then we will see how to create the custom class, immutable class. So there are some steps which must be followed to create the custom immutable class. Custom immutable class means once we create the object of that class, we cannot change the content or state of that object. Okay, we'll see what are the steps. First one should be our class must be final so that no other classes can extend it. You know, through subclass also we can change the state of super class. So we should not give that opportunity to any other classes. To avoid that one, the class must be as a final. And second point is make data members private. How many data members? 1, 2, 3, n number of data members we can declare. Those data members must be private so that direct access is not allowed. Okay, private members we cannot access directly from outside. Okay, and data members in the class must be final. Not only class, members should be final, so that we cannot change the value of them after instance is created. Okay, and there should be one parameterized constructor, so that in third point we made all the data members as a final. So we don't while declaring we don't assign the initialize the value to that one. So those values must be initialized, right? When we initialize those values through the constructor, while creating the constructor, so whenever we declare those final variables will be blank final variables, we will assign the values through constructor. That's why there must be one constructor, parameterized constructor. Okay, and getter method for all the variables. How many variables are there? Those many getter methods should be there. Since those data members are private, we cannot access directly by using from outside. Okay, and there should not be any setter methods. These are the rules must be followed while creating a immutable class. This is the very, 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 very important topic in Java, in object-oriented programming languages, as well as for interview also. So, with respect to immutable classes, generally we will get how to define the immutable classes. In that also, several interview questions are there, as I said. What is the use of final keyword? And how can we access the private variables? So many things are there. Okay, then we will see the example, practical, how to define the or create the custom immutable class. Before jumping into that directly creating a immutable class, we will see existing classes, how we can understand whether that is immutable or not. For example, I told all wrapper classes are immutable and the string class also immutable. So once we create the object of that class, we cannot change. If we cannot change the content of that object, if you change that, so new object will be created. I will show that one. If you see line number 7, string, I created an object of string. String name is equal to new string, and I passed value as Viresh. Okay, so this is the object, and I am printing here line number 8 hash code and value of it. Okay, so this is one. So next line number 9, just I am trimming the space, white spaces of that value. So value here, I am trying to modify the value of or state or content of that object. So by trimming that value. Okay, then again I am printing a hash code. You will see. So in third step, just I am not creating any new object, just I am concatenating another value to existing value. To Viresh, I am adding a noid, and I am printing again a hash code. We'll see whether those hash codes are same or different. Since I am creating only once object of that string, and rest of the places I am just trying to updating or modifying the content of that class. String is a immutable class. You might get a doubt, it is a immutable class, how you are doing the or updating the modifying the this string object. So we will see. And second, line number 14, this is the custom class HAP, and which contains only one private field or member, that is ID. So since it is a private, I defined getter setter methods. So whenever we create this update of this class, initially value will be default value, that is 0. Later I will update that ID value with some value, 100, 200, 1000, 2000. Okay, that means whenever we update the value of this ID, so state will be changed to of this object, app class object. As I said, see, I created app is equal to new app. I created this object of the app class, and I am trying to get the value of that ID, get method, through get method, and I am printing hash code. Later I am updating the content or state of that object by changing the value of ID, and again I am trying to get that ID and printing a hash code. So we will see what is the difference in this case. Second, this is the first case, and this is the second case. In the second case, in first case also I created object, and I am trying to do some modifications on that object. Here also same thing I am doing. Okay, string is a immutable class. This is a custom class which is not immutable. We'll see what is the difference between these two. I am going to run the or execute this program. There are several ways with a shortcut through keyboard, or else right click on this one, run as Java application. See, first I put system.out.println. In real time you don't use system.out.println, just for a demo purpose I used this one. So here system instance hash code line number 8, just I created the object of string class with the value Viresh. Okay, and I am printing the hash code. So name dot hash code, which is a method of object class. Okay, so what is the hash code of that object? This is the 767646, and I am printing value Viresh. If you see, space is there, here also empty space is there. So next line, line number 9, I am trimming that spaces. So again 1.1 line number 10, I am printing hash code and value of that string. So if you see, this hash code and this hash code are different, and here space is there, here nothing, no space is there. That means this is trim method trimmed and updated, modified the content of name object, and it created a new object and returned to this one. That means whenever we are trying to do some modifications on the content, it will create a new object. In all the methods, whatever methods are available in string class, if you use every method, will return the new object of the class. None of the method return the same object, believe me. That is the one important thing we should aware of, that one. Since we are using, your reference is same, but inside reference refers the address of memory location. This address is here, whatever reference contains the address of instance is different. This address of instance is different. How we come to know? So by seeing this hash codes. And in line number 11, I am just adding the value to existing object. That means I am concatenating the value to existing value Viresh, and concatenating Noid. So that in this scenario, again we are using same reference, but reference refers the different address of memory location. So if you see this one, I executed right a string instance hash code. This hash code is completely different, and this hash code is different. So these three hash codes are different, means three different instances are created. That means once we create that instance of the class, we cannot change. That's what it represents. So that is the case one. So case two, this is also class. This is a existing class, string is a existing class, app is a custom class. which contains only one data member, private data member, that is ID. So first I created a object of this app class, and I'm trying to get the value of that ID. Okay, and I have printed a hash code. If you see here, ID is 0 and app hash code is 2642. Then I am trying to update the or modify the state of this object by setting by changing the value of ID. Here I am setting ID value as 100 and I am printing the ID value by using get method, and also I am trying to print hash code. So here if you see this console, 2 dot ID is value because I setted value as 100. So here also I am getting 100. So app hash code is 2642, same, both are same. That means after updating or modifying the state of object, we are getting same address of memory, that means same hash code. So this is not a immutable. We can update the content of object so that there won't be any new instance will be created. That is the difference between immutable and mutable. Okay, let's jump into the our actual topic, how to create the immutable class, custom immutable class. Okay, I already defined one class, name is employee immutable, and which contains the two fields, private final int ID, private final string name. These are the, if you see this one, very first point is make your class as a final. So this class is final. And the second point is make data members private so that direct access is not allowed. So all data members, whatever data members are there in this class, all are private. In our case, only two are there, ID and name. And third point is data members in the class must be final. So final, private final int, private final string. Then third point is a parameterized constructor. So parameterized constructor. Why we need parameterized construction means these are, we just declared the final data members. So we have to initialize that one. So these are just blank final variables. So through the constructor, while creating object of this class, we are assigning the value to that blank final variables. And third point is getter methods. Getter methods are not there. So we can generate. There is a shortcut, Alt Shift S. So it will give this pop-up, generate a setter and setters and getters. So if you want both, you can select. So select all, and what do you want? Only select getters or setters? Only we need set get getters. Just click OK. Automatically it will create. We don't need to define the separate methods like get ID, get name. Eclipse is giving ready-made shortcuts. We can use those. Okay, that's it. So this is the immutable class. So do you see any is a opportunity to change the or way to change the value of this one? No, right? We are creating the object of this class by passing these values and getter methods. No setter method. There should not be setter methods. Okay, this is the way we can create the custom immutable class. Thanks for watching the video. Oh, sorry, I forgot to test this class. You will see test class. This is the package. Right click, new and class. Immutable class test. I'm not going to write unit test classes, just test with the main method. If you see here only we can select the methods whatever we want. Which method stubs would you like to create? Here public static void main is there. If you select this one, automatically this method will be added to your newly created class. Otherwise we have to write by manually. If you want to, you can generate the comments also. Do you want to add comments? If you want to, we can add. In real time scenarios we must add the comments so that if tomorrow new resource come to the project, they should understand, right? So that comments must be preferable. Like this, who is author and what are the parameters. This stub, we can delete that one. Control D, automatically it will delete. So I'm going to create a immutable EMP class object. Control space, automatically it will take IM space new. So okay, you might get doubt, right? So here immutable EMP constructor is there. This is not a zero argument constructor, right? We have parameterized constructor which takes two values, ID and name. Okay, we'll give ID is 1001 and name is Viresh. Oh, immutable class. Okay, this is different and this is different, right? Immutable classes is just for example I created. We should use immutable EMP. So we have to delete. Control D. Again, take new class. Immutable EMP. EMP is equal to new control space. It will give ID is 1001. And name is anything you give, Viresh. Okay, if you try to access directly, what will happen? We'll see. EMP dot ID is there, right? So, not get ID. What it is telling? Syntax, multiple errors at this line. Okay, we cannot access directly. That means control D and print through the EMP dot get ID. Shift home. Enter. Name. Right click. Run as Java application. 1000 Viresh. This is how we create the immutable class. Again, I'm going to show you steps. These are the steps important to define the any custom immutable class. Make sure class should be final so that no other class can extend it, and all data members should be private and final. There should be one final parameterized constructor and getter methods. There should not be any setter methods which will give the way to update the status of that object. There should not be we should not be added those things. Okay, these are the steps. Thank you for watching video.